Have you ever wondered what secrets could be hiding inside a simple rock? Or have you ever admired the sparkles of a diamond, wondering what makes up this stunning jewelry? If you're curious about the hidden treasures of our planet, you're in the right place. In today's video, I'm going to clear up the mysteries of rocks, minerals and gemstones. So get ready to dive into an exciting adventure where we will uncover the differences between rocks, minerals and gemstones, discover how they are all formed, and explore some super cool examples from each category. Whether you're another geology enthusiast like myself, or just someone who thinks that shiny things are awesome, also like myself, join me on this fun exploration of rocks, minerals and gemstones. Hello and welcome back to my channel. And if you're new here, I'm Maria and I'm a scientist and a geology enthusiast, having fun exploring and sharing with you the many wonders of our planet. While in the previous video we talked about giants, today we'll be exploring geological wonders on a slightly smaller scale. Let's first briefly define each material before moving on to specific characteristics and examples from each of them. A rock is a solid natural material composed of one or more minerals. A mineral is also a solid natural occurring material that is composed of one or more chemical elements. It has a defined chemical composition and crystalline structure. A gemstone is generally a mineral that is cut and polished professionally for use in jewelry. Now that we learned the definitions of rocks, minerals, and gemstones, let's try to understand them at a deeper level. And we'll start with the rocks. As I mentioned before, a rock is a solid natural material composed of one or more minerals. Depending on where and how the rocks were formed, as well as their mineral composition, we can classify rocks into three main categories: igneous rocks, sedimentary rocks, and metamorphic rocks. Igneous rocks are formed either from solidified magma or lava. To learn more about magma and the difference between magma and lava, check out this other video where I explain the science of magma. Some examples of igneous rocks include granite, basalt, rhyolite, and scoria. Sedimentary rocks are formed through the deposition of sediments, which are then compacted and eroded over time. Some examples of sedimentary rocks include sandstone, shale, limestone, and dolomite. Here is a fun fact about sedimentary rocks. Some of them are made almost entirely from the compression of calcium carbonate present in the shells of dead sea creatures, giving birth to limestone. Others are made from the compacting and weathering over millions of years of the material originating from dead plants, giving birth to coal. And finally, the metamorphic rocks are either igneous rocks or sedimentary rocks, which were transformed over long periods of time because of high pressure and high temperature conditions in their environment. As we've also seen in the magma video, varying the temperature and pressure conditions a material is exposed to can change its structure, creating a new form. Some examples of metamorphic rocks include marble, mariposite, novaculite, and soapstone. Now that we know what rocks are, the different types of rocks, and how they are formed, let's move on to minerals. A mineral is also a solid natural occurring material that is composed of one or more chemical elements. It has a defined chemical composition and crystalline structure. If you want to learn more about chemical elements and crystal structures, you can watch this other video about atomic, molecular, and crystal structure. One process through which minerals are formed is crystallization from magma. In this case, the chemical elements are brought together by their environmental conditions. Thus, the varying temperature and pressure conditions, as well as the chemical composition of the magma they reside in, shape the minerals in their crystal form. Another process that leads to the creation of minerals is precipitation from solution. This is what happens when there are too many particles in a solution, meaning the solution is supersaturated, and those particles come together to form a solid. That is what happens with the salt in the Dead Sea in Israel. The water is supersaturated with salt, and thus the salt minerals started precipitating into a growing layer of salt. My favorite case of mineral formation from precipitation is found in the Naica Cave of Crystals in Mexico. The Naica Cave contained a supersaturated solution of ions of calcium and sulfate, which combined with the water molecules to form selenite crystals. Being a closed environment, without anyone or anything disturbing the process for hundreds of thousands of years, this place was perfect for the growth of the giant selenite crystals that now inhabit the Naica Cave. To learn more about these giant selenite crystals, I have another video that is dedicated entirely to the Naica Cave. One important thing to know about the crystal structure of minerals is that each mineral has a unique crystal structure given by which chemical elements are present and how they are organized in the three-dimensional space of the crystal. The 3D organization is very important because some minerals might have the same chemical composition, but they are very different minerals due to the organization of the crystal's 3D lattice. To illustrate this, let's use the example of aragonite and calcite. Both of these minerals have calcium carbonate as the main ingredient, but their crystal structure is very different, leading to two different minerals with very different physical properties. Isn't it fascinating how similar and yet so different these minerals are? Other examples of minerals are pyrite, olivine, talc, and fluorite. With this greater insight into the world of rocks and minerals, let's now turn our attention to the glittering world of gemstones. But before moving on to gemstones, if you're enjoying this video, please hit the like button and subscribe to my channel for more videos about the many wonders of our planet. A gemstone is generally a mineral that is cut and polished professionally for use in jewelry. I say generally because there are some exceptions. One example is amber, which is not a mineral. Amber is a fossilized resin from ancient trees that solidifies slowly over time due to the various high temperature and pressure conditions it was exposed to. Going back to the gemstones that are minerals, it's important to note that not all minerals form gemstones. Gemstones are coming from those minerals that possess certain qualities. These qualities are 1. Beauty, which refers to their color and clarity. 2. Rarity, which tells us how uncommon they are. And 3. Durability, which is their resistance to scratching and breaking. All these qualities are leading to their high value in the jewelry industry. Gemstones can be precious gemstones and semi-precious gemstones. Precious gemstones are only 4: ruby, sapphire, emerald, and of course, diamond. Did you know that diamonds can have many colors? To learn what these colors are, check out this other video on the colors of diamonds. There are more semi-precious gemstones than precious ones. Some examples of semi-precious gemstones include amethyst, lapis lazuli, onyx, and moonstone. There are many other beautiful gemstones other than the ones I mentioned here. Let me know in the comment section what is your favorite gemstone, and I might highlight it in a future video. My favorite gemstone is opal, and I will definitely be creating a video about opals in the future. I hope you enjoyed learning about the differences between rocks, minerals, and gemstones. If you enjoyed this video, you might also enjoy this other video about diamonds, where I explain what diamonds are, how they are formed, and where they come from. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye!